Special cases of straight line. Let's draw the straight line x is equal to 4. In order to draw this line, we have to make a table of values for which we are going to record x as first column and y as the second column, and then we will make the pair of values. And if we are given that x is equal to 4, it means x is equal to 4, it's always x is equal to 4. There is no variation. 4, 4, 4, 4 means whatever the value of y is, x is always equal to 4. So if y was 0, x is equal to 4. If y was 1, then x was equal to 4. If x is equal to, if y is equal to 2, this is equal to 4. 3, it's always equal to 4. And from this, if we make pairs, this would be x, y, and the pairs we will get are 4, 0 and 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3. Let's draw these pairs on the grid and see what kind of straight line we obtain when we join these points. So 4, 0 is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. So the 4, 0 is a point right here. That is a point called 4, 0. And now let's plot the point 4, 1. So again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and it's 4, 1. So this time we have a point right here, and this is the point 4, 1. Next point is 4, 2. So again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 4, 2 is a point right here, and 4, 2. And next point is 4, 3. Obviously, all points are giving us a pattern now. That, and that pattern, it tells us that 4, 3 is here, and 4, 4 will be there, 4, 5, 4, 6, 4, 7. And that way, if we join these points, we are going to get a straight line, and that straight line will look like this. This would be the line, and we'll call this line as x is equal to 4. This line is parallel to y-axis. So guess what? Where would be x is equal to 2? X is equal to 2 would be similarly a line which will be parallel to y-axis, and that would pass through here. That would be x equal to 2. And similarly, if you would like to, what would be equation of the y-axis itself? Mean that if we want to draw y-axis, if we want to draw the line through here, this would be the line. And this line equation would be like, this would be x equal to 0 is the line y-axis itself, and if x is equal to minus 1, that would go on the other side. Like, pause the video and guess what would be the equation of the line, this line. This line would be equal to what? This line, would be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. So this line would be x is equal to minus 5. So any line parallel to y-axis has the equation x equal to k, where k is some number. If k is positive, the line will be to the right of y-axis, and if k is negative, the line will be to the left of y-axis. Now let's draw the next line, and what is the next line? Is draw the line y is equal to minus 2. Let's draw another set of axes here, and the other set of axes is that this is y-axis and this is x-axis. X-axis and this is y-axis. And now if we want to draw the line y is equal to minus 2. For drawing the line y is equal to minus 2, we are going to make a table of values, and here let's make two columns for x and y in the tabular form. X, like we always do, could be anything. It's an independent variable and its values could be 0, 1, 2, 3. Just four values are sufficient. Independent variable can get any values, whatever we want. We generally take few values either on the positive or negative side of 0. But for every value of x, y is given equal to minus 2. That's a constant value. So when y equal to minus 2 is a constant value, minus 2 is here, minus 2 is here, minus 2 is here, minus 2 is here. So the pairs would be x, y. Those would become 0, minus 2, 1, minus 2, 2, minus 2, and 3, minus 2. So where will these points go? If you want to plot 0 is here, and 2, minus 2, minus 2 is right here, minus will go negative. If y-axis, it's a negative y-axis. So 0, minus 2 will go here. And then it's 1 minus 2, and here this is 1 and minus 2, that's a point right here. That's a point, 1 minus 2, and then 2 minus 2, 2 minus 2 is a point right here, 2 minus 2, and then 3 minus 2, 3 minus 2 is a point right here, 3 minus 2, the pattern is clear now. And we can have a line, this line, y equal to minus 2 is a, this line, y equal to minus 2. So this line is parallel to x-axis. What if we want to draw the line y is equal to plus 4? So plus 4 will be above the x-axis, 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm sure this will be the line y is equal to plus 4. So y is equal to k is a line parallel to x-axis. Depending upon the value of k, if k is positive, the line is above the x-axis, and if k is negative, it is below the x-axis. But what about the if y is equal to 0? Y is equal to 0 is the equation of x-axis itself. So here is y is equal to 0. And we know that what is the equation of y-axis? That's x is equal to 0. So these are very special cases of straight line. And remember that these lines are sometimes required in order to solve problems. And what is the third question now? The third question is, draw the line y is equal to x. That's another standard line. And if we draw another grid here, if this is the grid and this is x-axis, y-axis, and this is x-axis. Now this is called first quadrant, this is called second quadrant, this is called third quadrant, and this is called fourth quadrant. The line y equal to x. There are two ways we can draw this. Either we can make its table and then plot the tabular data on the graph paper and draw the line through those points. Or we can use the point slope form like m value and c value, and using those two values we can draw the line Let's try this by using tabular form, and the next exercise, in the next question, we will do the C value and M value. So if we want to make a table like always, let's make a table right here and put these X values and Y values. As X is independent variable and we have a freedom to choose X values, so we are going to choose some negative values this time, -2, -1, 0, 1, and 2. It's perfectly all right if you want to choose just 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 or 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, whatever, you're free to do so. I just took these few values just out of nothing, I guess. Now the equation is Y is equal to X. What does this tell? It means that whatever the value of X is, Y has the same value. So from this equation, Y is equal to X. It means if X is -2, then Y is -2. If X is -1, then this is -1. This is 0, this is 1, this is 2. And what are the pairs? XY pairs are -2, -2, -1, -1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2. And if we plot these points, 0, 0 is the point right here, and 1, 1 is right here, 2, 2 is right here, and -1, -1 is right here, and -2, -2 is right here. So this is 2, 2, 1, 1, 0, 0, -1, -1, -2, -2. And if we join these points, we can get a straight line. And the interesting fact about this straight line is that it bisects, its equation is Y is equal to X, and it bisects the first and third quadrant. Remember this line, this is a very special line. Y is equal to X is a straight line, is a straight line which bisects the first and third quadrant. So now the last question we have is Y is equal to minus X. This time let's draw the X axis and Y axis again. I hope nobody hires me as a graphic designer. So this is X axis, this Y axis, and here we have the line Y is equal to minus X. Now this time, instead of using a tabular form, I am going to take a different approach, and I will compare it with the Y is equal to MX plus C. I'll get the values of M and C, and then I'll use those values to draw the line. Here, in order to write this in standard form, I can write 0 if there is no other number. So clearly, if I compare, C is equal to 0, that is not a problem. And M, if you compare the coefficient of X here, it's M, and what is the coefficient of X up there in the first equation? That's -1, so that's not difficult as well. So now, M is equal to -1 and C is equal to 0. What do we mean by C is equal to 0? It means the line intersects y-axis at origin. If y is equal to 1, if C is equal to 1, it means the line intersects at C is at 1 unit above the origin. If C is equal to -5, it means that the whatever the line is that intersects y-axis at 5 units below the origin. But in this case, it's 0. So definitely line is going to intersect or pass through y-axis at the origin. And -1, we can say M is equal to what? Rise over run, and that is equal to -1, and 1 is always the denominator, so -1. So where C is, we need to go because rise is negative, so we're gonna go 1 unit below. So 1 rise over run. So first we are going to run, so negative, and then run is positive. So run, this is positive, so we go one unit toward right and then go one unit down along the negative. So we reach here, one, this is run and this is rise. Once we get here, then we join these two points and we draw a straight line through these two points, and that straight line would be something like this. And this line is, its equation is y is equal to minus x, and it clearly bisects the second and third quadrant and fourth quadrant. See you in the next lesson.